Last time I explained that resonance takes place within the benzene ring. Do you remember the moving of all those double bonds? This time I'm going to replace the hydrogen on carbon atom number 1 by an oxide ion. There we go. Here you see the oxygen with the 3 electron pairs. In the picture we are right here at this moment. You see 2, 4, 6 and 1 makes together 7 electrons, and you know that oxygen only needs 6 electrons to be neutral. So we have 1 electron too many, and there it is. In this model we have 2, 4, 6 plus 1 is 7 electrons. Now the behavior of this oxygen has something extraordinary due to the resonance in the benzene ring. Oxygen draws its electron pairs with a force which is far stronger than all the other atoms. It has a value of 3.5 in the electronegativity scale. The value of all the other atoms is smaller, and yet oxygen is to let its electrons take place in the resonance of the benzene ring. It is prepared to share. How does this phenomenon work? Let's have a look. I move this electron pair towards the benzene ring. There we go. But then oxygen has now this situation. You see 2, 4, 5, 6 electrons. In the model we have 2, 4, 5, 6 electrons. Here you see the strong bond, there you see the weak bond. But this carbon atom has 1 electron too many. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this. So we are going to move this electron towards carbon atom number 2. You see, this carbon atom is now neutral, for you know that the number of covalents is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. But this carbon atom has one strong bonding here, one with hydrogen and one with the next carbon. And then we have number 4 and number 5. But we see that all the electron pairs are joined together. So this is a stable situation. Number 2 is called an ortho position. We are moving one electron to the next place. There we go. It is going to number 3. And what is the result of this? We see all joined electron pairs, but those two are single, and we don't like that at all. This is not a favorite situation. And they are too far away from each other to make a double bonding. We are going to see this time we'll move the one electron that was coming from the oxygen, we are going to move that to number 4. Watch this. We have a new position. Now we are right here in the drawing. The negativity, the charge, is right opposite the oxygen. And this is again a stable situation. Look, we have all pairs, no single electrons. This is called the para position. what is happening when we move the electron once again? We put it at number 5, and we see that we have 2 single electrons, which is not favorable. They are again too far away from each other to form a pair. We can correct it by moving the extra electron again one position. We go to number 6. There we are. There is our electron pair. Here is one, there is one. Number 2 and number 6, they both are next to the oxygen atom. They are both called the ortho position. And we have number 4 with the para position. Just imagine we would substitute another H atom by another atom or a group of atoms. Then this reacting particle has to have a positive charge to attack on the negative places within the benzene ring, and that will be most probably the ortho and the para position. As we have 2 ortho locations, number 6 and number 2, and 1 para position, number 4, the chance that we get an ortho substitution will be 2/3, 2/3, and 1/3 will be a substitution for the para product. In other terms, 66% will be ortho and 33% will be a para product.